Luther's wife very intriguing, and just like her in the house and her part in the Reformation and as Luther's wife. And so I'm going to talk more about like Katharina herself and her relationship with Luther. And Taylor's not going to touch that. Maybe. Since we overlap, just bear with us. And so I was intrigued by Katharina from two different sites. The first one was Luther's house. So we went there, and all the girls, we got a picture in front of her statue. And before we went to Berlin, like, I didn't even know Luther had a wife. And so figuring out that he had a wife was really surprising to me. And I've always thought of Luther as, like, a single man, because you always hear of, like, what he did and, like, made the Reformation his life. And I've never thought about, he had struggles enough as it was, like, with the Reformation. I never thought, like, home struggles was ever tied into that at all. And so learning about Katharina was super, like, I don't know, it was just awesome to hear for me. And so, obviously, the House of Luther is very important because it's the House of Luther, and Luther obviously started the Reformation. And Katharina herself, we saw in the movie, and I learned a little more about her, was that she was a former nun. And she escaped from the nunnery in, like, beer barrels or something like that with a few others. And something funny about their relationship that I learned was Luther didn't even want to marry Katharina, and he had married off, like, his monks with the nuns, you know? And so there was, like, pressure, and he did it out of spite to the Catholic Church, to the Emperor, and to the Pope. And ended up falling in love with her, obviously, and they had 6 children. And this is where she really has a huge play in the Reformation. So if you can imagine, probably not the guys, but the girls, like, being a wife itself is, like, that's a lot to handle. You know, just, like, being there for your husband, supporting him in what he wants to do, especially when he's Luther, who, like, is probably the most well-known person during this time. Most well-known either completely hated by people, where they, like, want to kill and execute him, or completely loved, where all the attention is on you guys. And, like, having a family to where there's no privacy whatsoever, probably no peace. Everyone knows what you're doing, like, all the time. And just living in a house like that, for one, that has to be stressful enough, being Luther's wife. And then to think she had 6 children, having 1 children to me is like, oh, that sounds horrible. But having 6 children, okay, I love children. Stop it. One day, not at 19 though. So having 6 children, like, just the duties that comes in as a mother to, like, serve your children as well as your husband. And so remember that he's a monk, and so their salary is not very high. And so when we were in the basement of the Luther's house, you guys, like, saw, like, the kitchen and all that stuff, and I was reading one of the plaques, and it was just like, but it was just like talking about how she, because they were so, like, low in salary, she had to come up with a lot of, like, their money that came in. And so, for one, she had her own brewery, and so she, like, brewed her own beer, which is a lot to do. And her and Luther had a garden to themselves that they kept up and, like, got their food and stuff from, as well as she had 3 other gardens herself. She cooked, she cleaned, did all that stuff. And to me, that's just super overwhelming. And, like, I just think about it. Like, how does she handle all that stuff? So that was really cool to me. And also, like, the biggest thing, besides supporting Luther, like, with his ideas in the Reformation, Dr. Smith helped out with this, but, like, she helped form a lot of his ideas. She was fully interacted in the Reformation. She wasn't just, like, out of the picture, which is why I'm surprised I never heard of her. But just, like, she helped him and supported him, not in just, like, being home as a housewife, but, like, fully in his thoughts and his theories and theology, and, like, stood behind him. And so everything that happened to Luther, like, if the Pope and the Emperor and, like, the Catholic Church hating him, like, she's linked to him. So whatever he went through, like, she went through with him. And so that stuck out a lot to me. And also, another thing, there's a portrait of Luther and Katharina in the historical museum in Berlin. And it was interesting to me because, especially after I learned about like all the things that she did for their household, on the portrait, on the top of the portrait, it says, "She will be blessed through bearing children." And to me, that's super ironic just because, like, she will be, but that's not all she did. And that's, like, a traditional, like, male and female, like, thought process during that era is that they have children and that's what they do. And then on top of